Hey, I firmly believe it is your birthright to be able to choose whether you want hair on your face or whether you want to be able to remove it. And I think it should be affordable, which is why I'm going to be showing you how to thread your own face. This has been around for ages, and I have so much respect for this method. I've been using it myself. I'm not a pro, but I don't think it's any secret that you should be able to know how to do this for yourself. I'm going to share all my tips so that you're able to try it at home. Give this video a thumbs up if you think this is helpful and you want to see more content like this. Let's go. I have hair all over my face, but the most visible hair is on my eyebrows. So I'm going to work on emphasizing both the brows and the upper lip because those are my two favorite areas to thread. What I've got here is a facial cleanser. I'm going to apply this to my skin and I'm going to clean the areas that I'm removing hair from. Whenever you're going for a threading appointment, a waxing appointment, or you're having a DIY session at home, it's really important that you make sure that your skin is clean before you start. Right after you pull the hair out of the skin, there's a really big opportunity for dirt and bacteria that's sitting on your skin already to just kind of dive into that pore and cause a breakout. I just want to mention when it comes to the upper lip, I don't have a ton of hair on my upper lip. You guys can see it here, but what I do have is a lot of pigmentation issues because the hair follicles are kind of dark at the base. The hairs themselves are really fine, but it creates a darker upper lip area, which is something I've struggled with for a really long time. What I've realized is that waxing doesn't remove every single hair, so that's why I like to thread. It removes the pigmentation that I don't like. Now my skin is feeling fresh and it's definitely ready to go. I'm going to show you how I do this whole threading thing. It's not easy, but it's not hard. It's kind of just one of those things you need to watch and learn for yourself. I'm going to show you with something a little bit thicker. This is not anything you would ever use for threading your face, but it's just thick enough that you can really see what's going on. So I'll show you with this first. I'm going to double up the rope and then I'm going to make it about as long as the fingertip to about just past the wrist, maybe mid-arm, and then tie it in a knot so that you have a loop. This is the motion you use for threading your face. Open one hand, open the other. Open, close, open, and close the other. And open and close. So the way that you get the blade of the thread is to twirl it around. This creates tension, so it'll wrap the hair up into this twist, and it'll literally rip it out from the skin. This is why it's massively effective for getting a really clean result, which it's known for. Threading has been known for that for like centuries. So now I'm going to show you with a regular thread. This is what I would actually use for my face. And I'm going to twirl it around 10 times and then get used to the motion of open and close. For your first few passes on your skin, you want to make sure that you're moving pretty quickly. You don't want to pull it slowly, otherwise A, it'll hurt more and you might not take out the hair quickly. What you always want to do is also tighten the skin. So if you have to stick your tongue out to tighten up your cheek, that is the most effective way traditionally in threading, and that's what I'm going to do for the upper lip area. You guys can see the hair, and you can see it's slowly coming out, depending if I catch it. Basically, with threading, you have to think about lines, and you have to make sure that you go in straight lines across and up your cheek and your face. That way you can remove all of the hair and not just sections of it. What I love about threading versus waxing is you can go over an area again and again. So I'm going to do this until my lip looks not only lighter, and if I see some extra hairs, I'm going to go back in and I don't have to worry about making the area too sensitive because we're not ripping any skin off, we're just taking the hair out. I also remove the hair off of my chin, and then I'm also going to do this just in and around the mouth area, which includes the cheeks right beside the upper lip, and that will complete that area of my face. I think the advantages of threading, like the money saving aspect, the fact that you can do this yourself easily and quickly, that's great. But I think that this isn't for everybody because it can be painful. I noticed for myself, even though I have a high pain tolerance to actually remove the hair, I'll get like a little cut on my thumb and there's an easy way to fix that. I'll just put a Band-Aid over it. That way, when I continue to thread my face, it doesn't continue to dig into my thumb. One of the disadvantages of doing this yourself is that you can't hold your own eyebrow in place to make the skin taut, which means you might risk cutting yourself. I often do this now that my skin's not as tight as it was when I was like 18 years old, so I'm noticing that holding my eyebrows up is my only shot at making sure that I don't cut myself a lot. But sometimes, like in this video, I actually do walk away with a couple little kind of blade cuts on my eyebrow, which do heal within like a day or two, but it's kind of annoying, and that's one of the reasons that I like doing my face with thread, but I actually prefer to go for a threading appointment when it comes to the eyebrows. So on days like today, my brows are pretty grown out. I would normally have gone for an appointment to really reshape these brows, but instead I'm gonna do a cleanup on my own, and I'm not gonna worry about the shape because moving the thread is an art of its own, and that's something that I'm continuing to try to get better at, but making sure that the thread follows where you want it to is a little bit difficult. So again, this is a fantastic practice for the upper lip, something that you can definitely save money on and do yourself no matter what. But when it comes to the eyebrows, you have to make the decision if it's right for you. Everybody who has sensitive skin should definitely follow the 24-hour rule. Once you finish your brows, your face, anywhere that you wanted to thread, don't wear makeup for the entire day, including the day after, and then only wash your skin the morning after your threading appointment. This will decrease the risk of a breakout and make your skin look really great. I noticed that I don't really break out after removing hair, but I try to follow this rule, and I know for people who have struggled with acne after hair removal, this has been one of the best things that I've heard that helps with that. So keep your hands off of your face. I couldn't resist a little brow pencil, but even I'm not going to wear any foundation today. My skin looks really good because I removed the hair. It looks brighter, and the upper lip is so much lighter. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.